of your street kings.
Yeah, my bad. I just wanted to do a little quick little tap in real quick. I was sitting here doing, you know, my research, observations, calculations, and stuff like that, trying to see, I guess trying to see why we are so animalistic, if that's a word. If not, then we got a new word in our dictionary, in our Ebonius dictionary, called animalistic. If it's a word, then cool. But why we so animal-like and savage-like? And a lot of us, we wonder how to get our energy levels back and how to get, you know, our health back in order and how to get, I guess, how to get people back in line on the right path we're supposed to be on. So I know a lot of us, we have of philosophical ways. We have, you know, prophecy ways. We have, you know, overly educated people, you know, 19Ps, Dr. Umar, my favorite, Baba, King Baba. I mean, we have a lot of educated people, Brother Ben, Rizza Islam, Lord Jamar, Malachi York. I mean, the list goes on. And my new dude, I think his name, Yaki, I believe his name is. Billy Carson, I mean, the list goes on with these educated people. I mean, we got Elon Musk, we got Mark Zuckerberg, we got, you know, Bill Gates, we got, I mean, a lot of educated people and a lot of people with money as well. But I say those names and I list those names because, you know, a lot of these people I just named off, I actually get inspired by it and I look up to and, you know, makes me go further into my teachings and into my studies, because those people I just named off there are my teachers as well. You know, because I know they teachers, they're just as good as me and them, you know, from Farrakhan and all of them. So, but why I say that we act so beast-like and animalistic and savage-like and stuff like that, it's because if we understand who we are, this is, you know, the color nature or the natural color, you know, because as we see a natural color, just like the hues in the rainbow. And I know when we tend to want to look at a rainbow or see a rainbow, we're looking for the sky to have a rainbow or water reflection to have a rainbow or anything like that. But in all reality, the rainbow is the trees, the sky, the grass, the leaves, you know, even the wind, the water, us, it's the solid gas and liquids. I mean, the rainbows is everywhere. Even our chakras inside of us is a rainbow. Those are all our gems. This is why we're called Jews, because we have the gems literally externally and internally. So when we look at all those things and all our gems, is ruby to orange to canary to emerald to sapphires, you know what I'm saying, we know the whole lineage all the way up to our purple crown, all the way up to our golden crown that goes all the way up to the golden sun. I mean, we understand all that. So if we understand all that and we understand that we genders and we come in as sex chromosomes and stuff like that, and male comes in XY chromosome, female comes in XX chromosome, and we also understand that if we see that, we gonna see XXX and Y. And we all understand what XXX is, so I don't really have to go too further into that. But this is why we are on such a sexual plane right now. Because we have a sexual plan right now. And when I say we, I mean amongst people. We may not be in the agenda of the sexual plan, but we are part of the agenda of the sexual plan, because the whole plan is to disorganize our gender and our sexuality. This is why they promote homosexuality so heavy and not spirituality. So when we look at that and we see that we are XX and XY, we should already understand that homosexuality won't even be allowed or wouldn't even be created, because an XY and an XY cannot create an XX or an XY, and vice versa. An XX and an XX cannot create an XY or an XX. So we already understand that even with, if we try to do homosexuality, it's not humanly possible to recreate or reincarnate us. So to get to the animalistic side, we see that our cows, I'm going to just say beef and stuff like that, they carry the same type of chromosomes with us, XY, XX. But when we look at our other set of chromosomes and our other set of animals that we like to eat, which is our chicken and our fish, they have the chromosomes of ZW and ZZ. So if you're paying attention or listening up, or, you know, however you want to do it, we see those letters in that alphabet. You know, I believe in the cows and stuff like that, they have two sets of 19 chromosomes, which will equal 38. And then, or I might have it wrong. I'm not going to say a specific animal because I might have it wrong. I have to do a little bit more research. It's just a quick look I did, and it made me get into this. And then we have another set of animals that have, I believe it was 56 or 58 or something like that. They have a bunch of chromosomes, but they only use two sets, an XX and an XY. Another 58, I believe, is not utilized. So then, like I said, when we go back to the birds and the fishes, chicken and the fishes, that's ZW and ZZ. So if we know our lettering was WXYZ. So if we have two sets of chromosomes, two sets of animals and stuff like that, male, female, we see that birds or chicken, I believe I'm going to say birds and chicken because they are still the birds that take flight. We have Z and W. So we understand W comes first. So now that we have W within that chicken category or that bird category, we have a W right there. Then we have X. So now we know that X with those animals will be the animals that we have. So we have a W, like I said, the cows and stuff like that. So they share our chromosomes as well. So we have W. I'm just going to say XXX because we share those things with those animals and the humans. So those three X's will be the animals and the humans that we share. So WXXX. And then we have those two sets of Y's. And then so it's YY. And then look at this. We have a group of two Z's. ZZ. Don't that mean we sleep? So if we see WXXXYYZZZ, why are we still asleep? Don't think that what that means? So with the fish, they ZZ. With the chicken or birds, they ZW. This is why I said ZZZ. Don't we got flying fish? Don't we got fish with wings that can jump out of the water? Or fish that dive and get into the air and go back into the water? So they naturally go from land and water or air to water. This is why they're the ZW. But then we got the cows and stuff like that who do not naturally go into the waters or anything like that. Our pigs don't naturally go into them. That's the other animal, the pig and the cow. And they don't naturally go into the animal, I mean, to the waters and stuff like that. When we see pigs, we think of pigs taking dirty mud baths, which is not true because they're related to the hippopotamus. And I learned this from one of the OGs, but they're related to the hippopotamus, and the hippopotamus is overly clean, just like the platypus. And, you know, there's a lot of relations amongst them. I'm not going to go down the line to get y'all the animals related because I'm not even about to get into all that like I know all that. But they're cousins and relations to the hippopotamus, and the pigs are related. So with the hippopotamus, is always clean with a bird or the animals on them, flies or whatever, always cleaning them. Why wouldn't the pig do that? Because if we know 100 monkey mind thinking, if 100 monkeys in South Asia can help and direct and teach the monkeys over in Brooklyn Zoo, then it's obvious they understand how to think together universally. So the hippo is already teaching other hippos how to be it, the warthog, the, you know, the, any of those animals that do that. Like I said, I'm not going to go down the line to get each other relations, but if they can teach that to each other, why would the pig be considered over here such a pinkish color when they're literally a melanated color, black, brown, with stripes on them, dots on them, anything like that? They're literally melanated creatures that still clean, just like the cousin or the brother of the hippo. I mean, they kinfolk hippo, but we feed them slop you know, all types of trash. We feed them slop just like we do our inmates, and we call them and treat them as pigs. But then they're getting patrolled by pigs who feed them that stuff, because in the outside reality world, pigs get fed trash instead of nutrients like vegetables, food. You know, the same way we will feed our dogs, or the same way we will feed our children. You know what I'm saying? The same way we will feed our children and our dogs and stuff like that should be the same way we feed these pigs and these cows, because we eat them. And like I said, when we eat them, we take in their chromosomes. We take in what they have as well. If they have problems or diseases or, you know, bodily structures that, you know, dysfunction them, it's going to come into us. We may not take the full thing in, but it comes into us. And I say that because this is how a lot of our diseases come into us. So when a lot of our diseases arrive in our body and they become unknown and it's in our bloodstream, we call it naturally, we have to figure out what's been in our bloodstream naturally that allowed these natural diseases to be in us. So then when I look further into that, I see like, okay, if we eat these animals as a sharing chromosomes as us, which is the beef and the pork, which they tell us to stay away from because they have sharing chromosomes, which is XX and XY. This is why they want us to stay away from the red meat or the bloody meat or the similar meat or the lower meat that comes from us. With the same as that chromosomes, because like I said, I believe it's the pig. I forget which one, but I believe it's the pig that has the two sets of 19 that equals 38. And I believe it's the cow that has the 60, but it does not use 58 of the chromosomes. So like I said, when we look into that, then we should see that this is why we are so beast-like or so savage-like or so animalistic or losing our ways or losing our energy because we picking up those animal type ways. So when Dr. Sebi was teaching us, and even Elijah Muhammad, I know I'm not trying to disrespect nobody, but a lot of us didn't even get an opportunity to even meet Elijah Muhammad. So the ones who actually had the opportunity to meet Elijah Muhammad or even get the word from Elijah Muhammad or pass the word from him on the eat to live, on how to eat to live and stuff like that, from us having whole food markets and our grocery stores and everything, when they were studying this stuff and understanding that the herbs and the trees and the seeds and the oils and the natural milks that come from dandelions and plants and stuff like that, when they understood that this type of stuff is a medication to our body and not just the fact that, oh, if we eat these things daily, this and this are happening and all that, when they understood these stuff was healing to our bodies and it cleaned out our bloodstream, that's when it became an issue. Because, and I'm going to say this, because we all know that the main issue that people had with Dr. Sebi was saying that he cured people of pretty much sexual transmitted disease or HIV or AIDS, herpes, chlamydia, syphilis, anything like that. But if we also understand that black people was also an experiment down for, you know, when they injected men with syphilis purposely. And you know what I'm saying? They injected us with diseases purposely. So if they injected us and did that, I think it was Tuskegee or something like that, when they did that experiment us and they literally sat there and they injected us with those diseases, it was in our bloodline. So even if, and I hate to say it, and I don't want nobody to take it in a disrespectful way, but even if we had a lineage of, just say, I don't even know the number, but I'm just gonna say, just say it was 1,000 black men, and those 1,000 black men all had a different last name, and they knew these last names was going to line with a different lineage of people. They injected all those 1,000 of people, so that's 1,000 people with a disease in their bloodline that just passed on to 1,000 women that these men choose to sleep with, and they had babies, so now it's in their bloodline, and then it's a constant pass on to the bloodline, because if they fill up a syringe with 100% of nothing but diseases and they inject 1,000 syringes with 100% of diseases in these people and they have to go through and constantly get this blood or the disease out of themselves and they inject it into a woman's portal, then that woman's portal was taken in as well. That same disease that came in with that man, he injected into the woman the same thing. It's like our penis is like the syringe. This is why they constantly want us men to be surrendering and submission and, you know, take away our kids and stuff like that, because it's like a syringe. If we can sit here and constantly inject our sperm cells into this woman and it makes and recreates not a disease, but it creates a human that brings ease to people, because that's all our kids do, it brings ease to us. we don't see it as an easing point because it's too easy to parent. So we find things that make it complicated. And I ain't trying to get off subject with the teachings of, you know, the meats and stuff like that. But this is how we become like this, because when we become adults and we grew up on eating these animals and stuff like that, even if we eat plants and fruits and vegetables or whatever like that, when we grow up in these type of mentalities, we raise our children in these mentalities. That's why a lot of people, when we do raise our children and we see certain things happening, we instantly get upset and we attack the problem instead of solving it or finding a solution for the problem. So when we sit there, and like I said, when Dr. Sabian and all them explained to us and understood that a lot of diseases that's in our body is literally just bloodline diseases. It's not a disease where we go out and, you know, I'm just going to be straight up. They say everything that a black person do, and a lot of white people, I'm not just trying to, you know, I'm just going to say humans in general. They like to say anything humans do that show love is a disease. And that's a disease of hate. Because if you can see a man and a woman kiss, but then you say this man and a woman got a quote unquote kissing disease, how would a kissing disease come along if we know that kissing is supposed to bring no harm? If we know that if we sleeping with a woman, and I'm just saying a woman because I'm a man, I'm not going to even try to intertwine the whole, but I'm a man. So if I sleep with a woman and I sit there and I know I'm making, you know what I'm saying, doing my 1-2 or anything like that, that's our connection with, you know, our chromosomes, and that's us. We cannot sit there and be like, okay, I'm going to sleep with the same sex just to recreate, procreate, make better, test the waters and stuff like that, because it fails us. And we constantly fail, we constantly fail. You know what I'm saying? When we fall and fail, this is what we do. We fall from the sky, we hurt more and more and more because we don't believe in the eye in the sky. We don't believe in the one who create. We don't believe in that no more. So people will look at it for a human structure to make her believe, or, you know, things like that. So when we come to these points of understanding that, when we have to lift our energy level, we have to lift our current, you know what I'm saying, we have to lift our electrical points, and we have to lift our solar energy, because it's a soul inside of us, and like I said, on the external of us, that we have to rise up and be able to literally expose on a good way. Because if we have that natural glow, that natural healing, that natural touch, that natural care, that natural love, like nature always does us, we ain't never seen a tree attack not one soul. So why do the souls go attack the trees to make paper to attack the souls of the people? These trees don't hurt us. The sun never hurt us. The leaves never hurt us. It's fall right now. These leaves ain't cut nobody, shot nobody, sent nobody to a hospital. When we cut grass, it don't hurt us. When we do any of these natural nature things with us, it doesn't hurt us. So us as natural nature people, we're the only ones with a voice. So why do we sit here and destruct our land that God built for us? If we say this is our secondary heaven, that means our first heaven must be destructive. If we destructing our secondary heaven, because if our first heaven is constructing, built with golden roads, diamond roads, mansions, and all this stuff that we believe, why ain't our home our secondary heaven? Because look, when we get a first house or a first car, we feel good and we take care and we say, well, shit, I can get 2, I can get 3, I can get 4, and we upgrade. We constantly get more because we already see that we took care of 1 or 2, so we go get more. Same way we make the kids. We take care of 1, we make 2. We take care of 2, we make 3. We take care of 3, we make 4. We always add in 1 more. Because we see that we are literally 1 more than what we became from yesterday. We 1 more step becoming better than what we was yesterday. And that's how dope we really are. But we don't see it that way. And I, like I said, I'm not trying to drag this on too long. But one more point I want to make is with this periodic table. When we see these periodic tables and we understand the elements that's in our body that we're supposed to use, and the elements that's around, period. You got to hear that word, elements. We have elements in our body: earth, wind, fire, water, and heart. You know what I'm saying? And when we understand earth, wind, fire, water, heart, or earth, air, water, earth, you know what I mean? Earth, air, water, fire, and then your heart complete the rest. Ain't that what the land is? the land on this earth is complete with what? More water than anything. So that means this right here, what we see, this is a body of water. Don't we have a lot of blood stream in us? Don't we have a lot of blood flow? Ain't it a lot of water flow out here? So if it's a lot of blood flow in our body and a lot of water flow on this body of earth, that means we on our body is on this body of earth with the same flow, the same go, the same everything. So when you see those five separations of the oceans, just think of us. Ain't that what we say? Arm, leg, leg, arm, head, ain't that five? And then one more, we see as God, so that make us six. Or we see us as God creation, that make us six. So then God is the seven up in heaven. So that know he's a seven. So once we make it to that level, we supposed to tell him, we supposed to build, not destroy. And he trusts us with that word. And he said, good, I'm going to bring y'all down there to show me what y'all going to build. And we're supposed to show that what we're supposed to build. And we're supposed to cipher that and give that to each other one by one. By the time we miss 100 and 1,000 and 1,000,000, we'll be on that same page to constantly build one by one. Like I said, I ain't gonna hold too long because I can go deeper and deeper and deeper. But like I said, I just want to let y'all know that in order to get out of these animalistic ways, these beastie ways, these savage ways and stuff like that, it ain't even about stopping to, you know, watch what we eat or anything like that. It's just stopping to watch how we treat each other. We can sit down to eat beef, steak, pork, and chop suey, wherever we want to eat all day. But that shouldn't change the ways of how we treat each other and how we see each other and how we need each other and how we feed each other and how we lead each other and how we guide each other. That shouldn't stop none of that. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. The top of top of top from the rock.
Give history kings.